जी नाज़रीन, दिल अपना पाकिस्तान के साथ इंतखाब अहमद। आज पाकिस्तान के जो 6 सितंबर पे पाकिस्तान कौंसल जनरल के घर पे जो तकरीब हो रही है, उसमें पाकिस्तान के बहुत मायनास लोग पहुंचे हुए हैं। तो मिस्टर कर्नल साहब हैं। कर्नल साहब, आप कुछ बताना चाहेंगे 6 सितंबर के बारे में? कर्नल साहब, आप कुछ बताइएगा।
जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम, माय नेम इज़ कर्नल खालिद मतीन एंड टुडे इज 6 सितंबर। As you already know, it's Defense Day of Pakistan, and Defense Day of Pakistan is in fact renewal of our all sacrifices that the armed forces gave during wars that they fought, and every year it is celebrated to bring to give a tribute to the people who gave their life for this sacred country, and especially with their blood today Pakistan is surviving against the biggest enemy, which is two times bigger than Pakistan.
Right to defend our country. Thank you Khalid sahab, thank you very much, congratulations. Ji aap kuch kehna chahenge aaj, short koi baat kehna chahenge 6 September pe?
Ji assalam alaikum, mera naam commander shehzad hai, maine navy mein serve kiya hai.
Ha mashallah
ji. Jo Pakistan Day jo hum manate hain, basically wo har zinda qaume jo hain wo apni jo past history hai, jo victories hain, वो जो लैंडमार्क्स हैं उनको याद करते हैं, और ताकि आने वाली नस्लें जो हैं उनको याद रखें कि उनके आबाओ अजदाद या उनकी हिस्ट्री क्या थी
और अपने आप को कैसे डिफेंड किया है।
पाकिस्तान जो है, अगर आप पिछले अगर की हिस्ट्री उठा के देखें तो पाकिस्तान इज़ ऑलरेडी इन अ स्टेट ऑफ वॉर फॉर लास्ट ओवर 3 decades. सो पाकिस्तान इज़ प्रीटी मच सेलिब्रेटिंग और डिफेंडिंग देयर कंट्री एवरी डे.
सो
एवरी डे फॉर द लास्ट 3 years इज बीन अ डिफेंस डे.
30 years
वी बीन इन अ स्टेट ऑफ वॉर एंड नन ऑफ द कंट्री इन द वर्ल्ड दोस बेसिकली आर इन दैट स्टेट ऑफ वॉर.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम. अस्सलाम वालेकुम जी. अभी बात हो रही नाज़रीन फ़ौज की और पाकिस्तान ने किस तरह डिफेंड किया है. मेरे साथ पाकिस्तान के एक मायानाज फाइटर पायलट बैठे हुए हैं यहाँ पे. और नसर हुसैन साहब आप बताइएगा कि पाकिस्तान का डिफेंस डे आज हम मना रहे हैं तो इस पे आप ज़रा बताइए कुछ तफसील पर शॉर्ट.
यार मैं मतलब फाइटर पायलट की ट्रेनिंग भी की है मैंने.
वेरी गुड.
और मैं ये ट्रैफिक कंट्रोलर भी रहा.
वेरी गुड.
और मैंने इंटेलिजेंस में भी काम किया.
वेरी गुड.
यार पाकिस्तान एयरफोर्स के लिए मतलब मेरा तो पाकिस्तान एयरफोर्स इज़ माय रोमांस.
यस
माय लव.
वेरी गुड.
मैंने 16 साल वहाँ यूनिफॉर्म में टाइम दिया.
यूनिफॉर्म में काम किया.
इट्स ऑल अबाउट
डिफेंडिंग आवर कंट्री.
हम लोगों का जो जज्बा होता था और जिस वजह से होते थे तो हम तो सारी ज़िंदगी ट्रेन ही इसी स्कूल
ट्रेन
के अंदर कब हो और कब हम हमारा कोई उसमें इशू हो. लेकिन अलहम्दुलिल्लाह पाकिस्तान एयरफोर्स आई कैन टेल यू नाउ इज़ डूइंग ग्रेट. अभी आपके सामने जो मौजूद है रिसेंट
27
गॉड अभिनंदन डाउन तो दिस इज पाकिस्तान एयरफोर्स.
यस राइट. ओके मेरे साथ साथ जनाब पाकिस्तान के सिविलियन लोग भी हैं. शहजाद है मेरे साथ. शहजाद कुछ बताना चाहे जल्दी से बताएं कि 6 सितंबर के बारे में आपके क्या तासरात हैं. आपको कुछ याद है?
हमने तो जब अरसा जो पाकिस्तान में गुजारा 6 सितंबर वाज बिगर देन फॉर अस फॉर 14 आवर्स.
दैट्स
राइट. उससे तो ज़्यादा ही हम लोगों ने हमेशा स्कूल के अंदर जो एहतमाम होता था स्कूलों के अंदर क्या बोलते जो तकरीबात होती थी राइट आउट शाइन 14th of August. पाकिस्तान इज अबाउट डिफेंडिंग दिस लिटिल गाय. दिस लिटिल गाय इज गोइंग टू नॉट टू बी मेस अराउंड विद.
यस वेरी गुड. वेरी गुड. थैंक यू.
Receive Canadians with roots in Pakistan and features community information and entertainment.
नज़रीन दिल अपना पाकिस्तान के साथ इंतखाब अहमद आज वैंकूवर कनाडा में 6 सितंबर की याद दहानी और सेलिब्रेशन हो रही है यहाँ पे कि पाकिस्तान ने किस तरह से अपने आप को डिफेंड किया जब रात की तारीकी में दुश्मन ने हमारे ऊपर हमला किया. और इस मौके पे भी पाकिस्तानी कौम पूरी तरह से यकजहती के साथ इकट्ठी है और पूरी दुनिया में इसी तरह से पाकिस्तान के जो ख्वाह हैं वो भी पाकिस्तान की पाकिस्तान ने जिस तरह से अपनी हिफाजत की और अपने आप को डिफेंड किया सिंगल हैंडली डिफेंड किया पाकिस्तान ने आज उस तकरीब का हाल आपको दिखाएंगे. जी तो पिछले दिनों यहीं पे इसी जगह पे कश्मीर सॉलिडरिटी पे भी एक बहुत अच्छी गैदरिंग हुई. यहाँ पे हालात पढ़े गए पाकिस्तान के सदर और वज़ीर आज़म के मैसेजेस भी पढ़े गए और ये एक कौमी यकजहती की एक और मिसाल आपके सामने आई.
I would like to extend my warm welcome to all of you and particularly our retired armed forces officers and friends from Indian occupied Kashmir, particularly Mr. Jasim Khan and Mr. Manzoor Wani. We are gathered here this evening to pay our respects to those shuhada and heroes who rendered invaluable sacrifices for Pakistan in the 1965 war with India. Today marks the 54th anniversary when our brave soldiers successfully defended the country against the Indian attack on the eastern border. The valor, courage and devotion to duty displayed by our armed forces remains a shining example for all to follow. Ladies and gentlemen, this day is also dedicated to the struggle of our Kashmiri brothers and sisters who have faced unprecedented difficulties since 1947. The recent actions of the Government of India following revocation of their autonomous status, and the resulting gross human rights violations have compounded their miseries, their right to self-determination. We will continue raising their just struggle for freedom at all levels and platforms. Pakistan is a peaceful nation and has rendered enormous sacrifices for world peace. I salute the gallant sons of the soil who laid down their lives while defending Pakistan and pay respect to their families for unparalleled sacrifices they rendered for our tomorrow. Under the same September spirit, the nation and the armed forces are determined to defend every inch of the motherland and safeguard the security and sovereignty of Pakistan at all costs. Pakistan Armed Forces Zindabad, Pakistan Paindabad. Ladies and gentlemen, we are highly honored to have amongst us some distinguished armed forces personnel who will be sharing their experiences with us today. So first of all, I invite on stage Air Commodore retired Sayyid Ghulam Mustafa to share his thoughts and experiences with us.
Counselor General, Vice Counsel, it is an honor to be here to talk about our experiences of the 65 war. We are very lucky that we had people who devoted their life to making themselves in the position of working for Pakistan. And if you recall, 65 war was one of those occasions where the nation was won, and also not only the nation was won, but our armed forces were working with each other, and we did achieve wonderful results. We will get an opportunity to show our valor again, and that we did recently. The Air Force did a wonderful job when Indian Air Force tried to find out which were the weak areas, and instead of finding out our weak areas, they learned that they were the weaker element. And alhamdulillah, the Air Force was able to do wonders, because his troops did not achieve any results. So the only thing that I would like to say about our own people, they are very dedicated. And people like M.M. Alam, who established a world record of shooting down 5 Indian aeroplanes within a very short period of time. And he was not the only one. There were so many others who were with us in the Air Force who were ready to go and face the enemy. And they did a wonderful job. And I don't want to make a long speech, but I do want to request you that pray for those shuhada who gave their life.
I now invite Mr. Shafkat Bajwa onto the stage to say a few words.
Mera naam Shafkat Ali Bajwa hai. Main Chunda ke gaon mein paida hua hoon. Aur aaj main aapko bataun ki mujhe pata hai ki bahut se logon ko nahi pata. सन 65 की जंग में मैं जंग में शामिल था. मैं कोई कमीशन ऑफिसर नहीं था, मैं कंपनी कमांडर एज ए मजाहिद फोर्स था. हमें 4 महीने पहले हायर किया गया. हमें कोई पता नहीं था कि जंग होने वाली है 65 की, लेकिन हमने ट्रेनिंग पूरी ली और 6 सितंबर को जब जंग शुरू हुई तो मेरी कंपनी में 120 पीपल थे और मैं ब्रिगेडियर अब्दुल अली, जो कि उस वक्त वहाँ के इंचार्ज थे, उनके साथ हमें लगाया गया. मेरा आज दिल कर रहा था कि मैं थोड़ी सी अपनी बात आपको बताऊं कि मैं भी उस जंग में शामिल था. तो बस मैं तो सिर्फ इतनी बात कर रहा था. शुक्रिया बहुत बहुत.
Thank you, Mr. Bajwa. Ladies and gentlemen, as I mentioned before, this day is dedicated to the Kashmiris. So I now call upon stage 2 Kashmiris, Mr. Jasim Khan and Mr. Manzoor Wani, to apprise us of the latest situation in Kashmir.
Ladies and gentlemen, assalamu alaikum, khawateen o hazrat. I'm Jasim, this is Brother Manzoor. Thank you so much, Dr. Saab, for having us, and thank you all for coming this evening. You are already well aware of the situation in Kashmir. It is not a secret anymore. It's been a month, just about a month now. Most of us have not spoken to our families. There is an intense communication blockout. It's unprecedented. Kisi se baat nahi ho pa rahi hai. Kisi ka ta pata nahi hai. Abhi recently, kuch din pehle meri ek yahan pe Pakistani friend hai, mashallah. Unka Kashmir mein ek dost hai, jinke saath unki business dealings hai. Unhone mujhe contact kiya, kaha aapko kuch pata hai unke bare mein? Can you find out something? A week later, I have absolutely no way of finding out. There is no way of reaching anybody. ये जो मैं यहाँ पे सिर्फ एक बात बताने आया हूँ, जो मेरा मेन मकसद आप तक पहुँचाना है, वो ये है कि एक ह्यूमन सफरिंग एलिमेंट जो है, अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह माशाल्लाह काफ़ी बुजुर्गों ने अभी तक बोला, यू बीन एनलाइटन ऑन वेरियस सब्जेक्ट्स, लेकिन जो एक ह्यूमन सफरिंग है वो अभी किसी बुजुर्ग ने फरमाया कि कश्मीरियों से बेहतर और कौन समझ सकता है. वी आर इन द कोर ऑफ इट, वी आर द विक्टिम्स. सो वो जस्ट वॉन्ट टू हाईलाइट दैट एलिमेंट एंड वॉन्ट टू प्रजेंट दैट यू दिस इवनिंग. There, like, honestly, it's been so difficult on every level. Aur alhamdulillah, hum yahan pe abroad hain, we are in safety, we're surrounded by amazing people who are supporting us in the safety, alhamdulillah, of blessings. But there are people who are suffering on every level. And right now, which is the biggest problem right now in Kashmir, is the wave of mass arrests. Left, right and center, bachon se leke badon tak wahan pe logon ko arrest kiya ja raha hai, including pro-Indian politicians and people who have always, for the past many years, been speaking the pro-Indian narrative. And that is the element I wanted to highlight to you, is the human suffering. Which brings me to my second part of that, is that this is, all with all due respect, I love events like these, but this is almost singing to the choir. Hum khud ko hi bata rahe hain, mujhe pata hai aap sab humse hamdardi rakhte hain, samaji, ikhlaqi, siyasi, sab hamdardi rakhte hain, hum sabko pata hai Kashmir ka masla hai, lekin bahar awaaz pahunchani hai hume. We have to raise this on an international scale. Aap jaise abhi Vancouver mein jayenge street, thank you. If you go on the street in Vancouver, if you ask somebody about Kashmir, they probably think about the Led Zeppelin song or the Kashmir wool. Aage unko kuch uske bare mein aage aur kuch pata bhi nahi ki kuch ho bhi raha hai wahan pe. Ye zaruri hai, grassroots level pe jo movement hai wo wahan pe chal rahi hai, lekin hame internationally isko grassroots tak pahunchana hai. Alhamdulillah, we did two very successful rallies, most of you were there, so I thank you from the bottom of my heart for all of you that attended, that supported us in every way possible, our journalist colleagues, our association colleagues, the embassy itself, on every level, alhamdulillah, the masjids, the MSAs, we received support from the community from all over the place, and not just from Pakistan, from everywhere. So alhamdulillah, we are very blessed, we are very thankful. So I wanted to take this opportunity at this stage today to thank you for the support on every level, to all the community members, bahut bahut shukriya. But lekin, it's not over yet. It's been a month and the situation has hardly improved. You know, ye masla hai aur hame isko international level pe lena hai. That is, I think, my core message, and I'll pass to Manzoor Saab to add if he has any more points. Thank you very much again, everyone.
Yeah, I just wanted to add to the same thing, is that we need to kind of go beyond the community that is sitting around here, the Pakistani community. We want to go, like, we have to spread the word at different levels. We have to engage at political levels. There's elections that are coming up. You know, we could meet up with the upcoming candidates and try to, you know, show them what's happening in Kashmir. We could obviously try to organize ourselves at grassroots level. Brother Furqan here, somewhere sitting here, has been helping out a lot in that regard. That's all. We could engage on social media. You probably see a lot of social media stuff happening, and a lot of that is a lot of rhetoric and a lot of propaganda. And for us to engage on social media, every one of us has to help out, because we are facing a very organized social media campaign. A lot of battles right now are fought on social media. And today being a Pakistan Defense Day, I want to congratulate you guys on the Pakistan Defense Day, and hopefully there will be a day soon that peace will prevail and we all will have a day where we can celebrate peace, and we're looking forward for a day like that ahead of us. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Jasim Khan and Mr. Mansoor Wani. I now call the Honorable Counsel General, Dr. Tariq, on stage to make his concluding remarks.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank you all for being here with us this evening. I'm particularly grateful to some of our guests here tonight, Air Commodore Sayyid Ghulam Mustafa, Colonel Retired Khalid Mateen, Commander Sabir Shahzad, and I'm particularly indebted to our friends from Indian Occupied Kashmir, Mr. Jasim Khan and Mr. Mansoor Wani. As you all know, the speakers have dilated upon these two subjects, Defense Day and the solidarity with Kashmiris, and they have left very little room for me to just elaborate those points. But I have to be very precise. As you know, that the messages of the President and Prime Ministers were fulsome and very elaborate. I would say that our armed forces have not only defended our external borders, but they also made enormous contribution to the country in peacetime, as pointed out Mr. Commander Sabir Shahzad. As you all know, at the creation of Pakistan, our armed forces had to start from the scratch. With the passage of time, the size of the armed forces has also increased, and at the same time, modernization of the army has also taken place. Besides increase in size, the army has taken into account all aspects, how to rise to the occasion and to cope with the adverse situation. As you all know, that the President in his message has pointed out that Pakistan is a peace-loving nation. Pakistani people and Pakistani armed forces don't believe in jingoism. In accordance with the Qaid vision, that we want peace within and peace without. We do not harbor any evil design against any country. However, our armed forces are fully capable to defend our borders and thwart any aggression against Pakistan. Internally, our armed forces have scored tremendous successes against rogue elements. With the support of civilian population, civilian leadership, our armed forces have successfully defeated terrorism through a very protected but successful war on terror. As you know, thousands of our soldiers have laid their lives in defending our borders as well as in war on terror, but the spirit of our brave soldiers have not dimmed. The existing better security situation, as you all know, is attributed to the valiance, courage, and determination of our armed forces. The courage and determination of our armed forces and the resilience have won the hearts of millions of Pakistanis, and today the people of Pakistan stand behind our armed forces to defend our motherland. Ladies and gentlemen, today's occasion, as you all know, is not just a symbolic. It unites people of all cross-section of Pakistani society. This occasion also brings us here to this gathering in Vancouver to know more about our beloved country. This also enables us to make a resolve to be prepared for any eventuality for our beloved country. Ladies and gentlemen, as you all know, besides paying homage to our armed forces, This event is also being held to express solidarity and to pay respect to our Kashmiri brothers and sisters who have been passing through most difficult time. As our brothers Jasim Khan and Manzoor Wani have elaborated in detail the atrocities being perpetrated upon civilian populations through the deployment of thousands of troops, arrest of politicians, restriction on assembly, arbitrary detention, as Jasim Khan has referred to as mass arrest, use of force, pellet guns, and communication blackout is unprecedented in Indian occupied Kashmir. The human rights organization like UN High Commissioner for Human Rights, Amnesty International have documented the massive human rights violation in Kashmir. You may also have read the reports that Kashmiri people have limited access to food and health care. They have not been able to reach out their friends and relatives in almost a month, as pointed out by Jasim Khan and Manzoor Wani. The Indian government claims that the life is returning to normalcy, but the international media has reported otherwise.
बुझा दिए तुमने बचा